shall return your bodies. Amen. The first Samuel. First Samuel. Chapter 25. Amen. First Samuel chapter 25. It's changed your lonely again. Amen. 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 I want y'all to turn to Samuel chapter 25, starting at verse 1. Amen? And the title of this message is, and I want y'all to look somebody in the face. I want y'all, and y'all know I don't do this often, but I need y'all to look at somebody. I need y'all to look at somebody right quick, right quick, right quick. And I want you to look at them and tell them, get mad.
Get mad.
But God gets even.
God.
Okay, look at somebody else. Look at somebody else. Look at somebody else. Look at somebody else. I want y'all to look at, and for real, for real, for real, for real, say this, say this, say this for real. Get mad.
Get mad.
But God gets even.
But God gets even.
You see, it's not up to us to get even.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But it's okay to be angry. The Bible says
right. We
can be angry but sin not. That's what the Bible says. And who don't we want to follow the word of the Lord?
Yeah.
How many really be wanting to put the word of the Lord on the side burner, on the back burner for a minute? Everything that you have learned, everything that you have heard, everything that God has told you, and just say, you know what, God, just go over there somewhere right quick. Let me just get even, I'll come back. Amen. How many? I know me. Amen. So I'm about to give y'all this word that God had given me. And I started out because it got a lot to do with a lot of different things. I want you to, even though I said get mad, but God to get even, I want you, listen, I want you to look at somebody else, look at somebody else, look at somebody else. Look at your husband. Look at your husband. Kiki, look at Sister Terry. Look at somebody. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Who got your Abigail? Who got your Abigail? Okay, amen, amen. Now Samuel died, and all Israel gathered for his funeral. They buried him at his house in Ramah. Then David moved down to the wilderness of Maon. Maon. There was a wealthy man from Maon who owned property near the town of Carmel. He had 3,000 sheep and 1,000 goats, and it was sheep shearing time. This man named Nabal and his wife Abigail was a sensible and beautiful woman. He had a wife, and her name was Abigail, and she was a sensible and beautiful woman. But Nabal, a descendant of Caleb, was crude and mean in all his dealings. When David heard that Nabal was shearing his sheep, he sent 10 of his young men to Carmel with this message for Nabal: peace and prosperity to you and your family and everything you own. I am told that you are shearing, it's sheep shearing time. While your shepherds stayed among us near Camel, we never harmed them, and nothing was ever stolen from them. Ask your own men, and they will tell you this is true. So would you be so kind, since we have come at a time of celebration, please share any provision you might have on hand with us and with your friend David. David's young men gave this message to Nabal in David's name, and they waited for a reply. Who is this fellow David? Nabal sneered to the young men. Who does the son son of Jesse think he is. There are lots of servants these days who are running from their masters. Should I take my bread and my water and my meat that I have slaughtered for my shears and give it to a band of outlaws who come from who knows where? Let me stop right there. Let me explain something. Let me say something. David, bottom line, was a man after God's own heart. But once David was anointed and appointed by God as the anointed one, all hell broke loose. All hell broke loose. When God finally chose David, David was minding his own business. Y'all got to listen. Y'all got to pay attention. Pay attention. David was minding his own business. David wasn't thinking about trying to be on the forefront. He wasn't thinking about trying to be chose, anointed. All he was doing was doing his job. What was his job? He was a sheep herder. That's all he was doing. And he was good at what he did. He was squirrely. He wasn't that big. He was cute, but he wasn't, his brothers was much handsomer, more stocky, everything than him. But Saul missed his promise. Saul was so disobedient and hard-headed that he made God strip some things from him. Sometimes we can get some things stripped from us that you'll never get back. Amen? And see, God says, I found someone greater than you. See, this is the whole thing. Now, I'm going back a little bit, but I'm going back for a reason. Sometimes your promise can be handed over to somebody else because of your disobedience, because of your hard-headedness, because you so puffed up, full of pride, you done got beside yourself. Amen? And so because of the mistake that Saul made, not only did God tore his grace, tore his glory from this man, everything was torn from him. Not only that, but he gave it to somebody that was told to be less than him. Listen. Saul already had it going on. And I think I'm talking to some people. You ain't have to work for nothing because it was your daddy's before it was yours. And it was your mama and everything. And all you did was take an inheritance of some things. Amen. And so automatically Saul was going to already have it. He was going to already have everything because he had an inheritance laid up. He already had a rich father. He already had it. And sometimes when you already got something and you ain't never had to struggle and everything been laid to you, handed to you on a silver platter, you don't know what to do with it. You get so prideful. You don't know how to honor God and give him great praise and all these things. And this is what Saul made a mistake at doing. Amen. And so this young boy, in the field, wasn't bothering nobody, got ordained, got anointed to be king. And he didn't even know he was supposed to be king. But he was anointed. God said, go anoint him, because see, he humble. That's the one. See, this one, he even got beside himself. He's smelling himself. He think he all that in a bag of chips. He think he got. I told him to do one thing, but he chose to do another. I told him to do it like this, and he said, well, I'm going to do it with a twist and do it like that. And sometimes we got selective obedience. We only obey the word when it's sufficient for us. Amen? Amen. If y'all understand, touch not my anointing. Oh, we good to say that. Amen. We good to say, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. But we ain't good to say if we are willing and obedient, then we'll eat the what? The good of the land. Amen. So we got the willing part, but we ain't got the obedient part. So you come to church, but you still ain't obedient. You come to church every week, but you're still doing everything. You up here, you preach, you teach, you lay hands, you cast out demons, you prophesy, but you ain't obeying God. God been told you to stop and you're still doing. I'm going off into something else and I don't know what's going on. But I'm going to tell you this. Nabal had it going on. But David, at any time, David and his men could have took Nabal out of here and all his people. But instead, David was a man of integrity. And he had some character about himself. And so he wasn't trying to take what wasn't his. But what he was doing was he was covering that man. He was protecting him and keeping all the wolves and everything away from that man's property. And so all David wanted was what was due to him. Give me mine. Give me that. Amen? Just give me what's due to me. I ain't asking for nothing more. Just give me some water, some bread. That's all I ask. And I'm cold right now. Could you cover me? And so this man that had it all said, who do you think you're talking? I ain't got to give him nothing. And so have you ever had somebody in your family, in your life, around you that can give you, can help you, and won't help you? You can pray for them. You can be nice to them. But when you down on your knuckles, they'll look their nose down at you. I ain't owe him nothing. Have you ever heard somebody say, I don't owe him nothing. I ain't got to give him nothing. I'll work for this. I got to pay my tithes. Who I'm paying them to? She don't deserve that. It's mine. I ain't got to go to church. I don't owe God nothing. Amen. Some people out here. So anyway, listen. So this man, Nabal, he told him, he said, look, I'll go on back and tell him I don't owe him nothing. Amen. And so he said, who this man think he is? I don't owe nothing. And so, listen, I'm getting to a point. Everything you do, do it for the glory of God. When you do for somebody, don't look for a reward. Don't look for nobody to return the favor. I'm serious. You cannot expect nobody to treat you the way you treat them.
Amen.
You got to get over. So David thought, because I was good to you, you're going to be good to me. Because I respected y'all going to respect me.
Amen.
Everybody ain't cut from the same cloth, baby. You might have came from the same mama, and they ain't the same.
Jesus.
Just because you came from the same mom out the same womb don't mean you're going to be the same. Everybody's an individual. So what you expect somebody to be don't mean they're going to be. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. You can be with that person for all these years and never think they'll do you because you would never do them like
right.
that. And they'll turn around and cross you out. Stab you in your back. Cut your throat if they have to. Amen? Because they ain't got your heart. And see, when you got the heart of Christ, you look out for everything. God, I can't. Even if I want to, I can't. Because that word, I hid it in my heart. I don't want to sin against you. So if I'm not going to sin against you, I'm not going to sin against my neighbor, my sister, my brother. Because God, I've got to have to be still accountable for this. Held accountable for this. Amen? And so listen, look. So anyway, where we at?
Jesus.
And so David's young men returned and told him what Nabal said. Get your swords, was David's reply, as he strapped on his own. He put a strap on what? He got strapped up. All y'all, get it. Put your gats on, everything. I'm ready to kill these. I'm ready to kill it. I can't believe it. I'm in need right now. I had your back. Do you remember when?
Right.
Do you remember when you needed somebody?
Right.
It's a time that man needed somebody and sometimes. Sometimes people look out for you and you don't even know they're looking out for you. Sometimes people have covered you and you don't even know you've been covered.
Jesus.
And then you ask somebody to pray with me to pray for somebody. I'm praying for them. I'm praying. And they prayed for you before they backslid. That's why you didn't backslide.
Uh-huh.
I got my own problems, my own issues. I ain't worried about that woman who husband had left her. I got my own household to deal with. Oh, well. Strap it on.